Hi, I'm Skill Singh, and on this channel, I help you build accessible web applications, cover data science concepts, and share awesome UI and ADA tips and tricks. In today's video, we will make the HTML table web accessible. Tables are used to arrange the data into rows and columns, which helps the end users to easily understand it. Sighted users can visually scan a table. They can quickly make visual connections between data in the table and their appropriate row and column headers. Someone that cannot see the table cannot make these visual connections. The proper markup must be used to make a programmatic association between elements within the table. With correct HTML markup in place, a screen reader user can navigate through data tables one cell at a time, and they will hear the column and row headers spoken to them. I will be sharing my recommendations at the end, so watch this video till the end. Now, if you are new to this channel, then consider subscribing and click that bell icon to receive a notification when a new video is uploaded. Alright, I created a very basic table by using div tags and span tags. I also use some of the CSS to give very basic styling. You can refer to this styling and the HTML from my GitHub. I'll be providing the link below. We will mostly focus on making this table web accessible. Alright, let's go to the top. We have this header element, and then we have this div element for this div section or the table section. This div is actually the parent container for the entire table. And to this div, we can assign a role, and that role should be a table. We'll give role equals to table to the parent div, and then we should have some ARIA label, which will be read by the screen reader. So we will say semantic HTML table, or if you want to go with this table itself, we can say grade results. You can also use a combination of area described by. I'll say area described by, and this should hold the ID of the element we are referring to. So we can use this header h3 header and put it here. Now when a JAWS or a screen reader is running, it will read grade results, and then it will say ninth grade results. Okay, now that we have added on these two attributes, the next one is to add how many rows are present in this table. And this can be set either static in case your table is a static table, or you can use JavaScript to set this attribute. So we have area row count, and let's count how many rows we have in this table. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 rows. So our area row count is 5. These all are the attributes needed at the parent level. Next, we have to add some of the attributes for the divs which are inside this table. Let's go ahead and add those. Now this div, which is our header div here, let me refresh this one. So this div acts as a container div for our header section, like serial number or the column headers, I meant to say. In that case, we can give role. We should have a role to this. We'll say role equals to, and then it should be row group. So we are grouping these elements, and we have to use the same attribute for other roles as well. So we'll go to this table body, and within this body we have a class called row, and this should have a role. Sorry, this body should have a role, row group, because these are the sections which holds our rows. Next, once we have provided the row group, we have to assign a role to the individual row as well. So we'll say role equals to row. So this entire section, serial number, name, age, and grade, is one row, and that's why we are giving role equals to row. Let's copy this section and apply it for all the divs which act as rows. We'll apply it to all the four rows within the body. Next, we have individual cells. So for each cell, we can say role equals to cell. And this should be applied for all the cells within each row. So I'll simply copy and paste it. We'll apply to all the cells section in our table. Almost there. And then we have the last row to which we need to apply a role. Alright, now that we have applied most of the attributes like role equals to row, role equals to cell to all the table elements, there is one more thing that we can do. In case you are hiding or skipping some of the rows, you have to mention the row index. So we'll go to this area. So the attribute for that is area-row index equals to, and then you have to specify which row index it is. So say suppose you are hiding the first two or three rows, and you have to specify this row index, and it should always be greater than one. In our case, we are not hiding any of the rows, so we can skip this and have a normal div without any additional attribute required. By the way, here's the collection of web accessible elements that can definitely help you develop web accessible applications. Coming back to my recommendations, I have these three recommendations. First, to use native HTML table elements instead of custom tables because of the inbuilt accessibility features they offer. Second, avoid tables with multiple levels of rows or column headers, and headers that span multiple rows or columns. Such tables may be difficult to implement with the correct markup and scope attributes, and even if implemented correctly, may be difficult for users to understand. I would recommend using multiple tables instead. Third, for empty table cells, use alternate text such as not applicable or no data available to help non-sighted users make sense of it. Now that you have made it so far, please help me by clicking on the like button and share this video with your friends to help them build a web accessible application to make their content available to all. Well, that's it. We created a web accessible HTML table. Please comment on which element I should make the next video. Till then, keep coding.